something. Yeah. Good cop, rolling with that bad cop. What you doing, boy? Turning that blood clock, buckshot. They fly through the truck spots, robots. Can't give a damn who the fuck shot. Clean cop, fucking with that dirty cop. Don't act like your ass never heard of that. Clean cop, rolling with that mean cop. Still trying to act proud as a peacock. You know.
So for me, ever since that whole George Zimmerman versus Trayvon Martin case thing, you know, it's been this white versus black thing. Even though to me Zimmerman looks freaking Hispanic, but it was like that. It's just started then, you know, like, of course racism and all that stuff has always been around, and you know, judges, whatever, people who like to judge people because of their race, it's always been around, but it's been heightened since then. And, you know, some of you may argue it's, you know, way before then, but at this time when this case was going on, I was only in 11th grade, 17 years old, and I was slowly coming to terms with the truths about this world. And I even made a video about the freaking case, but in that video, you could see clearly that I was programmed and brainwashed to believe these things. And now I know that Trayvon's dad was a flippin' Mason, and Trayvon was nothing but a sacrifice. A sacrifice? That's what he was, you know? If you guys know Scooby-Doo, a sacrifice? But yeah, I'll play a little bit of the video at the end of this video, and then I'll leave a link. I had a little YouTube channel, whatever, and I had Love and Hip Hop on there. It was just ridiculous. You guys might get a laugh out of it. I was really ugly. So you might ask, you know, why the title of this video is Pray for the Police Officers. Well, like us, they are people too, you know? We have been programmed into thinking police officers are the bad guys. You know, what I've realized lately is that police officers are honorable, actually. You know, they bring the peace and order of heaven on earth, you know? So that's their job. That's their role. And I just want to add that judges are held on that same regard. You know, the world itself honors the judges because they also bring the order of heaven. Judges wage war against hell on earth, basically. You know, they imitate the justice of God in a way. They see that there's a reaction and an action, you know. It's a reprimandation, really. That's the unholy, the idea of the justice system. The whole idea of the justice system is that they would be remorseful and turn away from crime in the same sense that they would repent and turn away from sin. So what are police officers? They are ministers of justice. If anyone watching this right now feels like they want to be an officer, you need to rise up for real, because they are really distorting the purpose of police. Like, have you not seen this? Like literally, God has made police officers his law keepers. And I believe that some, if not all, are filled with the Holy Spirit, and they might not even know it. But this is just my own opinion. Now, we got all these allegations against cops, and I'm not going to lie, I'm not saying all of them are faked or staged, but there's more than meets the eye, you know what I mean? Like, and these crime shooters, like, are being blasted all over the media, like these people who are with guns and all that and shooting up stuff, they're blasted all over the media to make us hate them. Hate. Hate is a strong, like, thing to feel. It's a strong action, you know? So, if we're hating because of what we see on TV, wouldn't we say that there's a reason, not only about people actually getting hurt and dying, but, you know, we don't choose what comes on the TV. So, of course, all they're going to put on the TV is negative things for us to hate them. You don't see how we're being forced to hate? Do you understand what I'm saying? Like I say over and over and over, TV was made to entertain us. Why should we believe the news that plastered an entertaining object? news that's plastered all over an entertaining object. Like, why wouldn't we question that? Why wouldn't you ask if God has his mark on something that man is trying to destroy it? These men and women bring the law of God and they are trying to make us hate them and kill them, like really kill the people that God sent out to keep the law, the land holy. Now, doesn't that make sense? I mean, it does to me. Destroy the local police so they can give it to the hands of the federal police, freaking detention centers and all that jazz. Seriously, doesn't that make sense? We're really sitting here hating the police officers when they are here to protect and serve, but our TV and our train of thought has been contorted by what they put on TV and what they want us to believe and think. So we need to wake up. Please share this video. Don't hate anyone, you know? Don't hate police officers. Pray for police officers. Some police officers are crooked, you know? And that's the ones you gotta pray for. You gotta pray for everyone. Okay, we just all need to have a big burn, a 24-hour burn, and just pray nonstop. Go take a dump, and then, you know, get back to praying. Hear from the Holy Spirit, you know? You got to pray for police officers. Don't hate them, because if you hate them, they're going to hate you, and then they ain't going to be nothing but a bloodbath. So, thank you guys for listening to this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Please share this video. Wake up some of your sleeping friends and family members that think that all white people are this, and all white cops are this, and cops in general are this and that. You know, also, just subscribe to this channel for more. And if you would like to help this channel, please donate to my Patreon. It's in the link below. By the way, my birthday is on the 12th. So that's cool. I'll be turning 24. But yeah, I'll be making another video about love. So stay tuned for that. I'm really going to try to record that video tomorrow. Right now, it is the 10th, 8:36. At night. Thank you guys for tuning in.
Yeah. So the main plot in this movie is ridiculously similar to Trayvon Martin's unfortunate situation, tragedy, whatever you want to call it. This is what happened to both of them, Cornbread and Trayvon. They were both leaving a convenience store. They're both leaving a convenience store. They were both wearing a freaking hoodie. It was raining in both situations. Did I mention that they were both black? So we all know why. We don't really know why Trayvon got shot. But the reason Cornbread got shot was because he looked like a suspect. A suspect in what, you might ask? A suspect in some, I don't freaking know. He just looked like someone to those cops that shot him in the movie. He looked like someone they were looking for. You know why he looked like that? Because he was black and he had a hood on. So yeah, of course he has a hood on. He's black. Of course he's guilty. Of course. I mean, he cannot be guilty. I mean, of course he's black. He has a hood on. My God, he looks so guilty. He looks like a suspect. He's running down the street. It was raining outside, what you expect. He had a hood on. You want to get a hair wet. It's just the fact that those two things are the same, basically, it's ridiculous. It's kind of eerie, creepy when you think about it. 1970s movie in a freaking 2000, like, you gotta watch that movie if you haven't seen it. But I'm gonna talk some more about
it. Did you hear how ridiculous I sound in that last clip, bro? If I could overcome and wake up and realize after saying and thinking all that, then anyone can. So I really encourage y'all to share this video and tell folks about it. And you can even tell the little bit of awakening I had even then, because I said that there's similar situations, you know, getting to the point that it could have been staged, because, you know, just this entertainment. You understand the two parallels? Anyways, I'm going to let y'all go. Thank you again for watching. Like and subscribe. Don't forget to donate to my channel. Love you. See you again this week, possibly, or at least next week. Okay, bye.